You got this. Hello guys, and welcome to my guide for doing the Veteran DragonStar Arena. Now this arena is located in North Kraglom. Originally it was only up to V14, but with the recent patch in the PC and soon on the console, you can now do it in V16. And it has some really interesting loots. This sword is incredibly strong. Puncture, that's like Ransack, it's from the one-hand shield skill. Heals you for 2.2k. If you can get infused, it's like 2.4k, and it gives you max health. Unfortunately, this stuff is random traits, so much like Maelstrom Arena, it can be a pain in the ass. But yeah, the sword's really good. The bow is also super strong, increases your weapon damage by 290 against targets affected by your poison arrow abilities, and adds 1k stamina. Again, that's a bad trait. You can get sharpen, infused to increase the enchant. You can get the staffs, which will reduce the destructive reach cost, which is quite nice for fire. It's okay for ice and things. I got it infused already twice. I keep getting this fucking ice staff. You can get it for all of the staffs. You can also get a two-hand sword. The two-handed sword's not that great. The maelstrom's much better. And the daggers are pretty interesting as well. I really want to test this. Twin slashes bleed for 249 additional damage every tick. And it adds a base weapon damage. So what we're going to be doing today is I'm going to be doing a guide of the full mechanics. Now this is all raw footage. I'm streaming as I go. So we actually have the resto stuff. I've got to explain this one. First tick heals stamina and it gives us max health. You got it infused. Not bad. Yeah, so I'm doing this as I go. I'm live streaming as I speak. So if I talk across my streamers, that's one of the reasons. But I will do my best to explain every single mechanic as we go. So first things first, let's start this shit. We talk to this chick. You ready, everyone? Just double check. You're going to need a tank, preferably a DK tank with chains. Chains is really invaluable in this, because if you have even reasonable damage, most of the shit you can just take in a big group and AoE. Then you're going to want a reasonable build. I'll post my build sometime later this week, or even maybe later today, for MSA, DSA, etc, etc. It's not necessarily optimized anymore. It used to be good for group trials. I have no idea if it's the best, but it works fine. And then you're going to want a Templar, because it does help a lot. That's the easiest way to run this. You got this shit? Jokes. Oh, okay. Alright, so yeah. First things first is the original wave. So each run of these has like 5 waves. Mostly it's pretty boring here. Especially the first one. The first one is basically just an AoE fest. He's just going to chain shit in, taunt, and we're just going to AoE. And everything dies super, super easy. So originally, this starts super, super easy. One thing I will mention is whilst I'm doing this, once I've actually finished it and uploaded the video, I'll try my best to break into sections. So if people have a specific wave they struggle on or whatever, I can post that wave on my YouTube, like in the description below. So if you are looking for a specific wave, you can look at that. Heavy bow, heavy attack or snipe for bow gank build. I would go for heavy attack. So again, like I said, this is all AoE at this point. If we get anything single, we can single target, but it starts very easy and that's wave one done. Up here you can see like the fires. This is there in every wave. When you've done 4 fires, the 5th fire is the boss, and each boss has a slightly different mechanic, each arena does. But this arena, the only mechanic is avoid the spikes, and honestly, you just stand here and you spin to win of your stamina, or spam some random AoE shit if you're Magicka. It's pretty easy. You're lagging? Goddamn. Our tank is lagging today. One thing to mention, by the way, is you do have unlimited lines. The only thing your lives will affect is your score on time, so it's quite possible we're going to die a couple of times. I'm not perfect to this, but I know all the mechanics, so that's the main reason for releasing the video. Fingers crossed that will help people. Anyone in the stream, by the way, if you want to ask anything, if you just want to chat, feel free. It's as per normal, I'm just recording as I go. Alright, so again, nothing complicated going on. We're just going to get more and more waves. Even in this wave, there's barely anything we focus on. If there's anything in particular you want to focus on, it's the Swordmasters, because they play something that heals them. It can save you a bit of time if you're going for a speedrun. But I guess most people who are going to watch this guide, it's going to be your first time, or you're going to be fairly new to it, so getting a speedrun doesn't matter that much. Your main focus is just going to be killing shit. But if you are going for a speedrun, you do want to focus the Swordmaster a little faster. That's this one here. The tank can even spam bash on these things, but generally it's better if the tank chains shits in, just because he places that heal ring on the floor. Once he's dead, again, it's just an AoE fest. Again, you're going to have things like healers, as per everything, just to interrupt that shit. Looks like the gladiators can place heal ring as well. I actually didn't know that. I think that's changed this patch. How's it going, mage? Welcome to stream, mate. I'm trying Mad Sword for VMA, but grinding is a bitch. Grinding is a bitch, but you know you can actually get decent XP in DSA. Shame you need to be a vet level. So yeah, that's one thing. You're gonna want to be a decent veteran level to do this shit. By veteran level, I mean champion points. Sorry, I keep getting that stuff mixed up. You're gonna want a decent amount of champion points. Like the vet, you're gonna need pretty solid DPS to do a couple of these mechanics. I'm gonna explain it for a group that has reasonable DPS. So I'm gonna do something slower than my group would normally do it. We're gonna do a couple mechanics we may not. If you're really lacking DPS, you can ask in the description if you're really struggling on a wave, and I'll do my best to explain how you can do it if you can't kill things fast enough. Because there's some things that you're going to have to learn. And another thing to mention is that even if you're like a regular DSA doer, there's a couple of mechanics here that I must have done this dungeon 200 times back when it was V14. And I actually did not know a couple of mechanics I learned recently, just because you used to be able to skip some stuff. You'll see on the Dwemer, there's one thing that I was told recently that some people found out. None of us even knew it. What's the best way to level on low player with no DLC? You want to go to Crackwood Cave, that's in the southeast of Cyrodiil. Okay, so you can see four fires. We're now going to get a boss. This boss is very simple. Mostly the tank has the main drop. We're pretty much going to single target and then spin to win afterwards. For the most part, we're just going to AoE adds, get all of the mini things down, then we're going to single target the boss. The only thing the tank has to be aware of is he places like a heal ring down, and that does makes him super tanky. It gives him insane health regen. So when that regen is down, that's when we need to quickly move the boss a couple of steps just to get him out of the heal ring. He also has that Dawnbreaker. Liz just met that, so do you mind to res him? Hello. You really don't want to stand in front of the boss. If you stand in front of the boss, you're going to die. So that's Liz's fault, that one. But yeah, don't stand in front of the boss. There's nothing you can do about it. It's a one-shot. Okay, there's the heal ring, so we just move him out and we fight him here. Easy stuff, and then he's going to chain everything in, and we're going to spin to win. It's really important your Templar is running Repentance and Shards if you're running Stamina builds or Elemental Drain. These fights can go on quite a long time, and if you're running like an optimized PvE build, your damage is going to be good, but your sustain's probably going to be fairly weak, so you are going to need that sustain to help, and that's where the Templar is going to come in. Another heal ring, so again, we just move him like this, and we fight him on the new spot. There's a few adds, so we spin. Do you want to chain those two, mate? So the ad just making sure that we keep all this stuff out of the AoE. Drop an ulti. Again, you want to spam these ultis pretty much all the time. There's some waves where we're going to save the ulti. You will need to me explain that, but most of the time we're just going to do that. This will probably be the last wave of ads. As long as... that's one thing there. You see when he drops those AoEs, you really want to make sure you're avoiding or blocking that shit. For the most part, I avoid. If you really can't, make sure you get your block up, because that happens. Fuck my life. And we're dead. Fiery Breath. Gonna get a res here. But again, it's just all an AoE fest at this point. We just melt these adds. It's already one of our worst runs. Couple of Diagros, but our tank is lagging, so it's not going to be the best. But in terms of mechanics, that's the main aim of this, just to explain the mechanics, so it's still fine. If you really want a speedrun, we'd normally restart at this point, but I think we're just going to go with it. It's fine. If you are really going for a speedrun, well, one really good thing to do is get your healer and tank to have Warhorn. Obviously, that wants to be the one level to give you the crit as well, because that's the main aim of it, to keep the crit up permanently. That will help a lot in terms of DPS, but it's not like you're forced to have that. And this Dawnbreaker again, we just stay away from that. He's nearly dead, we execute in 25%, and then we're done with the first wave. Easy stuff. Then we go on to second arena. So second one's got a little more mechanics. This first one's pretty bland. After each arena, we just go through this gate. Oh, there's one ad. Sorry about that. So after each arena, this gate will drop. We can go through here and we can get a chest. This can give you healer, footman, destruction mastery, and archer's mindset. Some of this certainly right now is worth a really good amount of money, so it's definitely worth doing. We got reinforced, so that's jack shit. Also, if you need to repair, if you're finding you're dying often, you can talk to this little scamp dude, and you can just repair at him, so that is worth doing in each round. PCNA is down, seriously. Oh, sad days. Okay, so round number two is the ice wave. So for the ice wave, we're going to have these three fires. At the start, it doesn't matter. In the second, third, fourth, and fifth waves, these fires are going to go down. So what will happen is... Hela, do you mind to do the fires?
Yep.
Okay, so Hela is just going to take the torch, and he'll relight the fire. It's pretty basic. You're only going to ever have to do one fire at a time. Sometimes on the boss, you may need two fires. We probably will. So we'll quickly explain what we do there when we get to the boss. But for the time being, all we do is melt these adds again. It's, again, just a chain job. It's pretty simple mechanics in this one again. Just these fires to keep an eye off. One thing to mention is these AoEs can be a little strong. The archer one there, the bombard and the charge, and the ice path particularly that the mages do, really important to kill those fast. They can do a lot of damage, so we just got to make sure we avoid that. Tank generally will try and interrupt it, so if you do have a good tank, he's going to keep on top of that, but sometimes it can be hard, especially if they're at range. Bombard in particular is hard to interrupt, but that's wave one done. It's pretty fast stuff at this point in time. place our AoE shit down, place our trap. You also have this chance to buff. You won't notice when the portals come up. You can't actually damage them in the portal. But what you can do is you can place your buffs. You can also hit them just as the portal despawns. So you do get, like, I don't know, half a second to do early damage. Again, if you are going for the speedrun. But for the most part, just chain, spin, chain, spin, chain, spin. Replace your ground AoE, replace your buffs, and spin again. And you're supposed to block that shit, but I'm too lazy. Like a scrub. Spin some more. What's actually up with the PCNA right now then? I'm hearing on my stream that a PCNA is down. So again, that fire hasn't gone out yet. You will notice that when it goes out, I will start to take a lot of frost damage. It will also snare you super hard. If you're the Templar in the group right now, when that fire goes down, all you want to do is make sure you got a heal that's healing the whole group pretty well. Be ready to cast Breath, because it does do a lot of damage. It's just important to get that fire up as soon as possible. And if you guys are just tuning in the stream, normally I would obviously have music on, but right now I'm just trying to make this a full guide for people, because a lot of people are requesting it. So I'm just doing that as I can. So you will notice that I'm commentating as I go. You can't log in. Sad days. Okay, we're going to place our Bluff, place the AoE. Now the Troll will do a bit more damage here. He does have an AoE. Generally, you want to focus the bigger mobs pretty early. There's some rounds in particular, like the Poison Wave, which we'll come on to later. There's some mobs that are really essential to kill fast. In this case, it doesn't matter that much. So I barely have a single target. It's pretty much spin, 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 spin. Wonder how many times I actually even say spin. I'll be interested if anyone's actually counting how many times I say spin in this shit, because that's basically all it is. In the starting waves, all it is an AoE fest. I guess they're doing a maintenance on the NA, there may be a bug or something. In terms of DPS builds, there's plenty of great guards. Outcast is pretty experienced with DK and stuff. And yes, I know there's speedruns. I'm sure if you asked him, he could help you. I'll release this Nightblade build. It's not like the best, I'm assuming. It used to be the best for like Big Charles. It's probably changed this patch, but it's generally okay. So what you see now is Hela quickly lighting a couple of fires. He's just grabbing the torch for us. There's normally a torch on each island. You see the ice? So my screen went a little blue there. But as soon as it's lit, it will no longer be blue, and then we have a fine. Your voice is not in sync. It's probably a tiny bit out. It can happen sometimes, but it's not the end of the world, right? Burn these last. Adds us another AoE to avoid. I think that's the final one, and then we're going to be on the boss wave. So these ones, again, are super, super fast. If you have nice DPS, you can get through this in absolutely no time. What race, actually, are you? What class are you? Stam DK? Hela?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So Stam DK is generally... I'm pretty sure Hela can confirm. Is Stam DK the best DPS right now? Still?
Yeah.
Sork, yeah. Sork is also good. Okay. So I'm going to Stam Blade. It's not the best DPS, but it's still okay. It's still going to be fine. Alright, so four fires. We're now going to get a boss. So this boss is a little different. This boss, I believe, is two. We're going to have a mage and a melee. You're going to want to focus the mage first, because he does a really nasty path. He can be a pain in the ass, because he can sometimes move in an awkward spot. The tank will taunt them both. We stand behind him so he moves towards the fire. That's something really helpful. Place our AoE down and just make sure you're interrupting that path, because he hits super fucking hard. Block all those AoEs and melt him. In a little bit, the fire will go down. Hela will keep on top of that. Red Guard is the best race for PvE? Yes. Hela wants to be a kitty cat, though. That's something else I could have interrupted there. I did miss it. The DPS is really nice, so hopefully we're going to be able to get this first ad down before this. As soon as the fire goes down, we'll then have to swap islands. So you may find sometimes he's going to step out the ice like this. It can be a pain in the ass then. If you're close combat, it can be really hard to hit him. So just use your best to reach him, but if you stand the ice, you're going to take a lot of damage. Careful of the ice path, careful, careful, careful. We're just going to AoE the shit now whilst the ads are there. Once the ads are down, we're going to go execute the boss, and that's the first one down. Then we have the melee left. Kashyyyk doesn't got sustain, but it has better damage. Okay. Apparently Khajiit is the best PvE race. I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Okay, fire's down. So at this point, we're going to go to our second fire. That will be this one here, generally, just because it's slightly closer. Hela will take the torch. Your healer is going to spam heals, pop a barrier if needs be. Generally, you're going to try to keep it warm, but it doesn't matter that much. He gets that lit. We'd stop taking the damage. We stop the snare. And then finally, we burst the final adds and the boss. There'll probably be one more ad wave yet, so we do have to keep out an eye out for that. What skill you replace surprise attack with, since you won't be a Stam Sork? You use rapid strikes with the Maelstrom weapons. You can get pretty crazy DPS with this stuff. I'm not the best. I'm still learning the sort of rotation for this. Sometimes I'm kind of clueless on it. I've never been taught it or anything, but... Interrupt the archer. If you do see anything archers doing that snipe, it's a one-shot. If it's not interrupted, it is an insta-kill. That's true in a ton of the waves, actually. So, really need to look out. Sharp, please. So, 10 bars obviously going to give us that shard. That will give us a bit of stamina back, if you didn't know. And then we're just going to execute the boss, and then we'll kill the last adds, finally. If you find you can't do it in two fires, if your DPS is a bit lacking, you can go to that third fire and do exactly the same with the torch. It's a little more difficult then, but generally you just want to burst that shit down fast. And that's the end of that wave. We'll get another chest. How's it going, Falooza? Welcome. So, now we are going to loot this chest. We are going to get Brace Archmine, not the best drop. And we got it instead, a pretty shit trait. And again, just going to repair our gear at the scamp. Check our weapons at Enchanted, etc., which they should be. We've just started. Here we go to the March. So this one is quite a hard wave compared to most of them. Certainly in terms of focus, you're going to have to focus a lot more on this wave than the others. There's a lot of large AoE, so it's quite easy to get a dire to. It's entirely possible we'll get a dire to. It depends how well we're running. I mean, we had dies in the first round, which just doesn't normally happen, so... We'll see how it goes. We'll explain this as we go. The first round is fairly easy. The second round, there's a few things we need to do. So your main targets are going to be this thing. Nereid needs to die as fast as possible. This does some really nasty AoE. You want to melt this as fast as possible. Single target. Once he's down, you're going to AoE. There's another one that you do look out for. It's like a Wasamu. It's this massive lightning lizard thing. Kill those nice and quick afterwards. But they should come after a lizard. And also some flowers in the later waves. They need to die nice and fast. But apart from that, again, just an AoE fest. So we're just going to spin to win this ship. A few crocodiles. Again, your tank, if you are the tank for your group, he's just going to keep chaining shit in. He's going to taunt it. It'll keep everything in the center, everything in your ulties. You can melt it nice and easy. It saves you a lot of time. If you're trying to single target this stuff, it can be a pain in the ass because you're going to have mobs all over the place. It's really messy. It's much better to use group play here. So that's going to be wave 2. I think at this point we get flowers. I'm not 100% sure on the spawns. The spawns you're going to see as I go will almost be a learning experience for me. I'm not sure if you get flowers. We do. So in these corners, you're going to get a flower. Not yet. But in these corners, sometimes you're going to get a flower. And what they do is they drag you across the arena. When you get that shit, you're really going to want to make sure that you kill them fast. Because it can be a pain in the ass. You can drag it into poison, which we're probably going to see in this wave. But yeah, Wasami should come first. We're going to quickly melt him. Just because he does a really horrible AoE attack. So you see those poisons there? That's the ones we're trying to avoid. That's just basically insta-kill. If you get caught in that, you can say bye-bye. So if you do see that coming... Make sure you get out of it. The flowers will also place a small AoE, but it's nowhere nearly as deadly. I'm about to see the flowers. So here's the flowers. You see that chain he just pulled in? That will chain you. If you're not blocking, you'll get dragged across the arena. It can drag you in the poison. It's really ugly. And there's the AoE they place. That's a lot of damage. You don't want to be caught standing in there. We're going to kill the last flower, and then we're going to kill the adds. All right. Wave 3. So wave 3 is going to have flowers here and here. I know this one. So hello, if you take that one there. And there's going to be a flower here. We're going to burst these flowers down pretty much before anything else can even spawn. And then we're going to focus Nereid and Wasami. But it's good to get these flowers down nice and early if you can remember the spawns. Like I said, I don't remember them all. I remember most of them. But it just makes it a lot easier. Then we're going to focus the Wasami because there's no Nereid right now. Again, really easy in this wave. It's just making sure you're avoiding all of that AoE. If you're not avoiding the AoE, you're going to get insta-killed. So... Do make sure you're avoiding as much of that AoE as possible. Not this last thing's done. Scrubber Weber, how's it going, Sinner? There's poison coming there. I could show you the mechanics, but it's going to one-shot me, so I'm not going to do it. So here's the Nereid. He's going to be our focus real fast. We're going to kill him as fast as possible. You'll probably hear him do like the scream. It's like, or some shit. I don't know what it sounds like. What that will do is it'll place like a massive damaging AoE on the ground. If you're standing that, you're going to die, plain and simple. So he's got to go, focus the flowers, and then AoE. Again, that poison, keeping sure you're out of the poison. You may find if you're on a MacBook, by the way, or a sort of lower graphics PC, it can be difficult to see. So my biggest suggestion is make sure you're on a TeamSpeak group for when you're doing this dungeon. If you're not on a TeamSpeak group, you're going to suffer really badly in terms of gameplay. And I would always suggest probably having one person who's done it. Unless you're a group of friends, then it's okay. It's good to have one person who's done it just so you know they spawn. So it's going to be two more flowers in the corners again. We're going to kill this nice and fast. And there's also going to be a Wasamu. We're going to kill him. So I'll take the flowers. And Honky will take the other one. And we're going to kill him. That's that lightning I was saying about. It's really horrible damage. And also the poison again. Keep an eye on these poisons. It can be quite narrow. The best bet is to stand in these sort of areas around the middle where you can hide in the gaps. It used to be that people stood in the corners, but that can be kind of clustery right now with the amount of damage you take in V16. So I wouldn't suggest it. Liz, do you mind to res? Oh, never mind. If you do get a die right here, it can be super difficult to recover from it. Because generally you're going to want the healer to res. So it's nice to have an off-heal. If you're a super strong group, you may not need an off-heal. But there's going to be a lot of waves where if the healer dies or if the healer needs to res, because sometimes it's better for the healer to res, sometimes not, it's worth it to have some kind of heal for yourself. I generally suggest running one off heal for this dungeon, just in case that shit happens. You're not forced to, but it's going to limit the amount of wipes you have, and that can save you a lot of hassle. Even though it may be a bit slower overall if you have like a super no die run or something, overall I would say this is better. Is this going on YouTube? Yeah, I will upload this on YouTube. That's the main aim. That's why I don't have music, because otherwise it's going to copyright me. Okay, now we're going to get the boss. So on the boss, we're going to focus the mage. There's going to be a mage and a melee on this one. We need to the plant first. I take the left, you go to the right. Kill the plants fast. Okay, I take the right. He's dragging me across. This is just going to save us a lot of hassle. And then we're going to go over and kill the mage nice and fast. This mage can be a pain in the ass. He does like this really nasty attack that's like a bomb in the floor. But it is interruptible, so as long as we're keeping an eye on that, we're fine. The main part of this is avoiding the poison. As long as you're avoiding the poison, it's fine. And as long as, again, we're focusing on the Nereid and the Wasamu, or whatever the fuck you pronounce. That heavy attack is interruptible, so all we do is interrupt that. You can't dodge it. So if you're the tank, just make sure you're avoiding that, unless you're in a massive AoE there. Oh, it's Honky Tonk. So that heavy attack is interruptible. You can't dodge it. It will just follow you around. So you do want to make sure you are just interrupting him with a bash, or whatever the hell your interrupt is. And right here we're going to get adds and flowers. So we're going to quickly AoE this stuff. Obviously a little more focus on the Wasamu where possible, because he's a bitch to kill. And he does his massive attacks. He can one-shot your thing, so we get him down as fast as possible. And then we just go back to the boss. He's going to die, we're going to execute him, and we're back on the mage. Where even is the mage? I'm not even sure. Here he is. As soon as the mage is executed, this gets much easier. So it's kind of handy if you can kill the mage before the second wave adds. I'm not sure how much DPS you guys have. Obviously, there's tons of different viewers here. So make sure that your DPS is pretty good. If you do struggle with how to DPS, there's plenty of guides. Again, Outcast is really good for that stuff. He's quite an experienced PvP. And the S is good. I'm sure Deltia has some guides out there. We're just going to AoE this shit. And there's going to be a Nereid in this corner. Or the front or somewhere. It's a Nereid somewhere. Maybe not. Next wave of adds then is a Nereid. But for the time being, again, we just AoE this shit. Oh, okay. Here we go. So we're going to kill the Nereid nice and fast. I was right. There is a Nereid. Once he is dead, we can basically focus the boss. And then we're done. And we're good. It may take you another wave of adds. If you do have another wave of adds, it's absolutely fine. Just take your time. Make sure you're avoiding the poison. Kill this stuff nice and fast, and you're all good. And we just AoE the adds, and we're done. But yeah, this is one of the harder waves. If you do have struggle on this, time struggles, just make sure, again, poison is your focus, Nereid is your focus, and Wasamu is your focus. But then, kill the adds. Is there something left? No. Here we go, and take our loot. None of these loots can give you the master weapon, by the way. Only the final chest cam. But you can get some stuff worth decent money off this. That is not one of them. Sturdy and light armor is generally not the best. Yeah, let's go through to the next dungeon. Slave Pit. Alright, so this one has these things called Enslavers. They proc a beam on you. Apart from the boss, all we do is kill it as fast as possible. Apart from that, this one's super easy. I think the tank has the harder job on this. There's quite a few adds. The healer doesn't have too bad a job. As long as you're staying close together, you can just out-heal the beams. When you have the beam on you from these enslavers, which you'll see in a bit, what will happen is when the beam ends, you're going to have like a black one on the floor, and that is unkillable. So it's quite important that you keep those near the wall. If those come near the wall, half the AoE is going to be like up the wall, out of the way, and it can make your life a lot easier. But first wave is nice and easy, so you're not going to see any of those. It's just pure AoE at this point. The second one, you're going to see some of the mechanics coming in. So we're just going to quickly mount this stuff nice and easy. So I'm gonna have a quick break on talking. I can breathe now. There's basically no ad that takes priority. I guess if you're finding this, you want a single target. Always mages and archers should come in that order, because archers can do one-shot snipes. It can drain your resources and later things. Mages can have some nasty AoEs. But for this one, you don't really need to focus. It's basically everything the same. Just AoE everything. And again, keep interrupting any attacks. If you see red sparks around it, if you are a much newer player and you want to try this, if you do see red sparks around the boss, just make sure you're interrupting that stuff. It will save you a lot of hassle, because it's going to be something that you could take a lot of damage from. If you interrupt it, nothing at all. Alright, so now we're going to get enslavers, and they're going to spawn on the right-hand side. I believe the first is here, but I could be wrong. It could be on the left, but it's somewhere on this side. They always spawn on this side of the map, apart from the second wave of the boss, where they're that side. And all we're going to do is we're going to kill these as fast as possible. They're going to proc that beam, and then they're going to do a spin. The spin is really nasty DPS, so you want to get them down nice and fast. If you do get the spin, and certainly everyone does, you just want to avoid it. So that's the one the beam happens. When he procs that beam, you're going to get one of his back ones. You cannot kill those. Doesn't matter what you do. Well, actually, maybe you can now, but in the end, you don't need to kill them. It's best just to avoid them. So we're just going to spin the rest and keep focused on the enslavers. Spin all the ads and easy stuff. But yeah, generally, you want to try to keep those beams so it's going on the wall. So you see that AoE? Half of that would now be up the wall. It means you don't even have to think about it. How's it going, Ted? Welcome to the stream, mate. Did I fight that Magpar who fought Fengrish? No, he's on a different server to me. Oh, am I that Magpar? Ah, you too. Okay, easy stuff. Are you late? A little bit late, Leon. We're on one of the later rounds. Okay, this time there's going to be two enslavers, I believe. The first one spawns either here or here, and then there's the second one. I can never remember which is which. There he is. He's in this corner. After doing it a lot of times, you can generally learn the spawns. It's been a while since I've done, like, lots of this. Don't get me wrong, I've done 10 runs in 3 days, but in terms of learning, like, the exact spawns, it can be a little harder. It's going to take practice, but it's not, like, essential to know that. As long as you're aware generally of where they're going to be, you can get it down nice and easy. The enslaver's dead. He's placed it by the wall. It's a lot less hassle then. And let me just kill the rest of the ship. I'm pretty sure there's a second enslaver wave. Certainly on most of these, there is a second pair. Here he is. So again, we're going to kill the enslaver fast. He's proccing that beam. It drains a lot of health, so the healer is going to have a hard time. You're going to focus your heals, generally, if you're a healer, on the person with that on. And then we just spin to win this. Execute a little early there, my bad. Another enslaver this side now. I actually wasn't remembering this one. So we kill him nice and fast. Again, avoiding that spin. That spin kills you incredibly fast. This is your favorite round. This one's pretty cool. It's a nice mechanic. But the boss takes a long time. So this time there's going to be two enslavers this side. That's on the west. Just going to kill those nice and fast. Whilst he's spinning, he might as well AoE. You can't really single target him. And then we're going to melt him. Out of that AoE real fast. Dump our ulti. And kill him. And then spin to win. Now we're going to get two enslavers on this side. Quickly kill these two enslavers. Let's. Stay with the group, hum. Quickly to kill the two enslavers on this side nice and fast. Get those out of the way for the group. So I would say in this round, generally, the DPS, if you're close combat, it can be a little hassle with these spinners. If you do struggle with that, you can always slot, like, something ranged, I don't know, spam silver bolts or flying dagger or some absolute crap thing just to kill those. But for the most part, you can wait for the spin. Obviously, it can be a hassle if you're a less experienced group, but generally, it's fine. And now we're going to have the boss. And this boss is the most annoying boss in the whole thing because he has a lot of health. What's left? I don't see an ad. Is there an ad?
That thing behind you on the tank.
Oh, okay. Tiny thing. Okay, so now we're going to have the boss. This one pops massive damage here. It's like 500k. And it takes a long time to kill. But the mechanics are really basic. All that's going to happen is we're going to keep getting those beam guys. And in this case with the boss, we're actually going to ignore the beam guys. We're just going to keep the beams away from us. And keep moving with the boss. So as soon as we drop the shades, those little black ones with the beam, we're just going to avoid. The people with the beam are generally going to stay closer to the wall so they're out of the way. And apart from that, we're going to focus the damage on the boss. But he has these huge damage shields. So this one is going to take you a long time to do. You see, you place it on the wall like that. It's so much less hassle because that AoE is out the way. So I now have the beam on me. You'll see me move closer to the wall, so I'm out of the way. Just keep it ranged for a sec. There's no rush on the DPS. I'm just showing the easiest way. Normally I'd probably just ignore it and we'll just move for the boss. We're trying to show you the easiest way. He's placed on the wall and we move back to the boss. Easy stuff. The only person who may not be able to move near a wall is the tank, because generally obviously he's going to have a harder time. But since he's going to have control over the boss, it's not the end of the world if he can't move too easy. Flying Dagger is your favorite ability. It's a pretty cool one. Where even is the boss? This Cinderstorm is something you're really going to want to avoid. It is fuck tons of damage. It's a huge snare. When he plays that, he's just going to move out of it, even as the tank. He's also going to place a Magma Arm, which is like an ulti. That shit is free hit kill. As soon as he plays that, you just want to kite him, so just move around a bit. So I have the beam on me now. I'm going to move closer to the wall. I'm going to drop the shade there. I'm going to go back to the boss. It's actually quite funny, you know, I get so many of these times in my videos where people are like, I just come for the English accent. Well, today you're going to get like an hour plus of it, maybe an hour and a half depending on how the run goes. Even more if it goes really bad, but hopefully it doesn't. So far it's okay, apart from the really terrible dies at the start. We haven't died since. He does petrify you there, just CC break that, it's nothing complicated. Again, it's really, really easy this bit, you're just moving away from all this AoE. Move the beam so it drops the guys on the wall, it makes it as easy as possible for you, and DPS the boss through the shields. Kill the adds when they come with AoE, but nothing is really going on this boss. If you're dying on this boss, generally, it's mostly because you're messing about with the AoE. So I now have the beam. I'm just going to be close to the wall. When bosses try to DK, exactly. Except this one's mean with his Sinistorm, man. This Sinistorm hits hard. So Honky Tonk now has the beam. He's just going to move away from the group a little bit, so it's not on us, as you see there. He moves just a little out of the way when it's close to the end. It just means it's out of the way for you guys. With 50% health now, get in there slowly. You'll see that his damage shields keep coming up when he pops the Igneous. It's a real pain in the ass. Just going to AoE hit. It is a real pain in the ass, but it is the mechanics. It won't surprise me if they nerf the health for this one a little bit, because really, since the mechanics don't actually change at all. Could I have a spear, please, Liz? Since the mechanics don't change at all, it's like fairly pointless to have so much health, but I guess it punishes you for making mistakes or something. I don't know what their excuse is. Careful of that AoE there. And at this point, we're probably crisp to just burst the boss. I have the AoE. There's the Magma Armor. So this one we really have to stay away from. It's tons of damage, even for the tank. If we get caught in that stuff, it really can kill you fast. If you've got a much more experienced tank, they may just be able to tank it with a good healer. But for the most part, I generally say just kite it. It's kind of nasty. Oh shit. And now we are probably going to be in execution points. So we're just going to kill the boss. Is this for your YouTube? Yes, this will be on my YouTube. So most of the people hearing me saying it will actually be on my YouTube. You'll see there, Liz taking the spinner away from us just so it's out of the way of the group. Another spinner there. Honky Tonk now has the beam, so he'll move a little way as the beam ends. Now we can execute, and we're basically done with this shit. Watch out. If you do find you're having stamina problems, by the way, using like generic damage builds, you can always swap to like one reduced cost. I would generally suggest against recovery, because the recovery's not going to be that relevant since your cost is going to be practically 100%. I would say reduced cost is better. But if you can hold the better damage, it's obviously going to speed your time up here. We're done on there. So let's quickly hand this stuff in. We get another chest. We can get some good loot from here. This time we got the footman set. Divines. That's like 10k right there. Easy money. Not that I need it, but it's something that you can use in the future. If you want to play this set, you could sell it. Whatever suits you. Next arena. I can't actually remember which is next. Alright, so this one is going to be seriously dependent on your damage. What will happen is on some of the waves you get a shadow caster spawn. What he'll do is he'll turn you guys blue if you can't kill him fast enough. When you go blue, these platforms will light up. There'll be four of them. So you'll take a platform each, you'll run onto the platform, and you just keep safe. It'll have like a blue glow around it. Stand in that shit, and it'll keep you safe. But what I'm going to show you generally is the mechanic to skip that shit. So there is none in the first wave. In the second wave, there is. Can you request a song? You can, but it will come up after I've done this DS rerun, so when I do the rest of the stream, because this one I'm recording, mate. If I play any music right now, it's going to fuck the commentation off, because it will keep me for copyright or something. Even though I'm not really using it for anything. Okay, so yeah. Nothing really complicated happens in the first place. You do want to keep on top of the mages and the interrupts. Those mages hit super hard. If you have Deep Breath as a DK, that's a nice one to use as the tank. You could also just obviously bash, depending on your stamina and magicka. But if you do have space for the Deep Breath, it's a nice way to do it. That's obviously the other morph of the Dragon Breath that gives you the heal. So one makes it cheaper, one does an AoE interrupt. I've become a PvE scrub. I'm trying to farm all these loots for a while. But yeah, I'll be doing some stuff on stream later. I'm slowly going to make some PvP builds, guys. Don't worry. But I have to farm this stuff to get some of the best builds. You guys want to see interesting builds? It's what's got to happen. Okay, so wave 2. Again, nothing too interesting here. When the Shadowcaster does spawn, he spawns here. But I believe it is the third wave, not the second. But I could be wrong. But if we do see him, he'll spawn here. Here he is. So it is this one. We kill him as fast as possible. Dump all your ulties on him and we get him down. If we can get him down fast enough, we skip all the mechanics. You'll notice we're not going to go blue now. All we're going to be able to do is kill the adds. Appreciate the follow, man. Much love, Hybrid. And if you guys are watching me on YouTube right now when I do upload this and you want to see this live, just check out my Twitch. It will be linked in the description below. How's it going, Pirate Mate? Welcome to the guide for DSA. How's it going, buddy? Good to see you here, mate. One of our best supporters. In this dungeon, you generally want to focus the gargoyles. They do pretty nasty DPS. Keep on top of any archers when they're using the snipe. But for the most part, you want to keep an eye on the gargoyles because they can do a lot of AoE damage. When he does that bash hit on the floor, you want to keep him down. So get them down nice and fast and then go back to AoEing. But honestly, this round is, again, really simple as long as you keep it on top of the Shadowcasters. Okay. Now, I believe the next Shadowcaster is on the left, but I could be tragically wrong.
Yes, he is.
He is. Okay.
The 2 seconds
up here. One up because you're number one? We'll see. We're going to burst the Shadowcaster again. If you do have ulties, you're going to dump it on him. It's not the end of the world if you don't. As long as your damage is okay, you're going to get him down. But if you can't, again, just remember those blue mechanics I said earlier. Go on the platforms that are lit up and you're fine. Too true. We've got to fight. We got to fight for the best supporter here. Hey, don't worry, guys. I appreciate you all for tuning in. Okay. Now we're going to AoE. We do get the gargoyle again, so he's going to be a little more of the focus. You can AoE if you have a stronger group. For the sake of interest, I'm going to show you just single target the gargoyle a little bit and then AoEing. But it's not the end of the world, as I said. Just blitz this shit down. Focus the gargoyle. Execute him. The tank will normally... He's just missed them, I think, just because you grabbed those two adds. Tank again will normally grab all the adds in just to save yourself some time. Make sure you're blocking any UEs or avoiding any UEs. Do you know how hard that is to say slow, quickly, AoE? 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 Just ignore me. I don't know what I'm saying. This is what happens when I do DSA too much. PvE on me kills me. And we're done. Do you remember if it's left or middle now?
Oh, it's here. Yeah, left.
Yeah, okay. So next one is on the left again. We're going to get another Shadow Dancer. I'm not sure if it's off the bat or not. It's not.
But it's not direct.
But once again, we just want to stand near the spawn to kill those. I'm interrupting the snipe. Got to keep on top of those. And don't always rely on your tank, guys. If you're in a real group, there's no point in you relying on your tank to do that shit. If you can interrupt something that he's not near, do it for him. Like, why the fuck should he have to do that if you're next to it? Yeah, coming. So again, we get the Shadow Dancer. We're going to dump our ultis on him nice and fast. Kill him ASAP. Really nice damage for us. If you are a healer, you could also slot Jesus Beam. You did notice our healer doing that. The quicker you kill that stuff, the better. So do slot Jesus Beam as a healer. There's a lot of points where the healer is generally just going to be able to damage. Again, that is going to depend on the group strength. But if you can purely damage, it's going to make life so much easier. And then once the Shadow Cast down, we're just going to AoE. And then we're going to be on the boss wave. So the boss wave is quite cool mechanics on this one, I believe. Obviously, I'm going to skip most mechanics because we have nice damage, but we'll show you generally how you can skip that at least. So boss spawns over here, and there's going to be a Shadow Dancer on the right just by here. We're going to kill the Shadow Dancer as fast as possible, then we're going to move the boss in that general direction because the second one spawns over there. That means that we're instantly on top of it, so he's going to spawn on this square here. Again, we're just ultiing. The Templar can help DPS. Once he's down, everything is easy. And then the tank will slowly but surely move spot. You're going to kill the Gargoyle as we go, rather than the boss. Whilst it isn't the end of the focus, you want to make sure that gargoyle's down, because it can be kind of a hassle for the tank. It's a lot of damage. It does hit a couple of times. And then we move the boss, and the tank will generally tank the boss about where I am here in these arrows, because it keeps it away, and the boss can drop a banner, and we want to avoid that. Manibeth is still broken as fuck. I have been informed about that. 4 a.m. here. Holy shit, you're already up, mate. That's pretty impressive, pirate. You mind to take him a little closer, mate? Like here? Willem, can you bring boss here?
Oh, yeah.
The reason we take the boss here, guys, is that in a bit there's going to be a Shadowcaster spawn on the door. The closer we are to that, the more likely we are to get them in an AoE. So what we want, optimally, is for the boss to drop his banner and then the add to spawn, the Shadowcaster. And that means that we can hit them both with our damage. It just, again, saves you a bit of time if you can AoE them. But you cannot stand in that banner. It's going to kill you. Doesn't matter if you're a tank. Haven't slept. Holy shit. You're going for the all-nighter. There's that banner. We're going to quickly move out of that. It's horrible damage. The tank can survive it just about, but I would suggest him to move. It's just pretty ugly. So he's generally going to move closer to the gate a bit. If he can't, he won't, but... Do you mind coming this way a bit, mate? Just so we can hit him. There we go. And then the banner goes and we focus the boss. To be fair, Sinan did last 21 hours, the whole 21-hour stream on my 24 hours attempt. Because we didn't quite last the whole thing. Very soon there's going to be a Shadow Dance. You might have to move him a little closer, mate. Like here. Wellen, come here, please.
Yeah, sorry.
Very soon there's going to be a Shadow Dance spawning near the door, so we just keep the boss a little closer to there. It just means we can AoE them together and we have more closer access to the boss. The tank will keep him a little way in case he drops the banner whilst we're killing the Dancer. But once he's dead, we're basically done. So... We've skipped most of the mechanics here. And here we go. Here he comes. At this point, we're going to burst this as fast as possible. All ultis are going to come down. We're going to drop ulti on both if possible. Quickly burst him and execute. And we're done. So you didn't get to see the blue ship, but it's basically... You're going to get a blue beam around it. It's very obvious. And you go in the even more obvious shining platforms. And that's all you do to survive if you can't get the damage. But if you can get the damage, it's going to save you so much hassle. You cannot even believe it. You last about 17 hours. Hey, that's pretty good, Ted. Lasting 17 hours is pretty damn good. I was actually amazed I lasted 21 in honesty. Now we're just going to keep our buffs up. I don't know if I meant to keep the crit up or not, but I generally do. And then we're just going to execute. Once he's dead, we're done. Next arena. We got a really good time right now. It's a shame we had the free dies at the start, because they're the only dies we actually had. It's going to cost us on the vitality bonus. Pretty good run so far. Epaulets of the healer, sturdy, shit trait. Again, repair that guy if you ever need to. So if you are finding you're dying a lot, make sure you repair him between rounds. You can also just accept Wayshrine. You do have a few seconds, it's like a portal inside that you can port to. This one's a little harder, so this one's where the mechanics start to get a bit more complicated. Alright. So, at the very start, we are just going to have a really basic wave. There's nothing going on at all. The second wave is going to be an archer, and this archer is where the mechanics come in, but I'll explain that as he spawns. For the time being, once again, chain, spin, done. The majority of this dungeon is just an AoE fest. It's a really cool dungeon, though. I'm going to be farming it a lot on stream and off stream, because I really need to get the set from this. I need the Master Sword. It's super strong. I need the Master Bow. It's super strong. I need the staffs. They're super strong. I also need the MSA ones. What got you? Oh, the Lurcher?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. There's one more die, but it doesn't matter. All we're going to do now is AoE. It is very important... Oh, shit. I'm resing the healer. Can you taunt? It's really important that the tank aggroes the Lurcher first. The Lurcher is a one-shot on basically anything not blocking, so it's quite important that you're getting him early. If you do find you're getting hit by an arrow, you'll see this green shit on the floor. When you get the archers, I'll explain the mechanics. But if you do get hit with the arrow, that I'll explain in a little bit. You want to go in there if the healer is ready for it. You've got to make sure they know about that. Because what it will do is it will keep your resources up. But basically, when the archer spawns, he's going to give you an arrow. It will hit you if you don't dodge it. You have to dodge it. There's no other way to kill it, to avoid it. If you do avoid the arrow, you're fine. If it does hit you, it will drain your resources to zero like fuck. So... It's very important that you do try and dodge that. If you do get hit and your healer is ready, you can go in that AoE and it will heal your resource up. But it does a decent amount of damage, so generally it's better to just avoid it or try deal with the no resources. Burst these adds. And then we're going to get the first archer. And the first archer spawns in the center. So wave two, one fire is done. He's going to spawn in here. No idea if it's first wave or second wave. I think it's first. But when he spawns, you want to kill him as fast as possible. Is this build on my YouTube? No, but it will be. So generally, it's good to keep spread out. He's on me. I'm going to dodge, and you'll see the arrow goes into the floor. It means no one loses resources. If you are in a group less experienced at seeing who the arrow is on, you generally want to call the dodge. I'll probably end up doing that on some of the later ones just for my group. But you just want to make sure you're avoiding the arrow, because it will save you a lot of hassle if you can. But most likely, you're going to see the drain at some point. What are the DSA weapons? I'll show you at the end, mate. But later on, I will show you the DSA weapons. At this point, all we do is burn the adds. I'm not sure. Is there a second archer in this wave? Potentially. I'm not sure. If you can learn the spawns from this video, that would help you a lot, because I can't remember all of the archer spawns. I know most of them, but not 100%. Alright, there we go. So, I believe now the next one is here, the next archer. But I could be wrong.
I think so.
Okay, so here he is. Again, we're going to kill him as fast as possible. You're only going to have to dodge one arrow that way. If you've got really insane DPS, you might have none. It's yours. So Honky Tonk's dodged it, like so. And then we just burst him. And he's dead. That's hassle done. Is there two archers in this wave or one? I can never remember.
I don't know.
Any idea, Hella?
No. No idea.
I think if there is a second one, it's in the middle. So can we go there? Either middle or right. But yeah, at this point, again, it's just an AoE fest. If you do see an archer, we may well see another one. I can't remember exactly. We're going to quickly burst the rest of the adds down. It looks like there aren't. Yeah, here on the left, there's one more archer. Dodge. So Hela's hit by it. Now he's going to have fuck all resources. It's a real pain in the ass. You'll notice it if I do get hit. Maybe even if we're really close on the bot, I can let the boss hit me with it. But you'll see exactly what it does. But it's not good to get that shit. You really don't want that. If you stand in the green, you'll get it back. But yeah. That's wave 3 done. Wave 4 archer, I believe, is on the right-hand side on wave 2. He's going to spawn over here in the corner. So we're going to start our boss over here. Someone's linking you my current build in the chat, mate. Sinister Chop. We got our excellent mod crew today. Again, he's going to taunt the lurcher ASAP. That is a lot of damage if we're taking the hits from that. Burn him down as fast as possible. And done. Now there's going to be an archer spawn here. We're going to kill him nice and fast. Dodge. I don't know. Did you manage to dodge it? Okay, it was on Hela, so we dodged it. He will shoot that arrow as many times as it takes to kill him, guys. So you want to kill him as fast as possible to avoid the amount of dodges you need to do. You do want to play the Elder Scrolls, but you have Star Wars The Realm Online. Man, Elder Scrolls is a great game. You should definitely get this game. It's pretty good. It's always good to grow the community. So we're going to burn these final adds, and we're all good. Now we're going to get the boss. On the boss, he's going to spawn with a big archer. He actually spawns here instead of the normal middle. In the middle is a lurcher, so the tank is going to focus the lurcher as first aggro, not the boss. You may find you have to dodge an attack from the boss, but the lurcher is obviously insta-kill. He's going to aggro the lurcher, then he's going to aggro the archer. I generally will keep him interrupted during that time, and then it's just generally an AoE fest to kill this stuff, including the lurcher. Right now we're going to get the dodge to dodge that arrow. As you see, it goes into the ground, and then we burn the boss again. Do you have an ad? We're going to quickly kill him. SA's 50% off on Steam, then there's your chance. Make sure you get that snipe interrupt. So he will put a snipe, dodge. Our healer just got hit there, so she's going to have fuck all resources. It's extremely bad if the healer gets hit. It's probably the worst possible outcome, because they obviously means you have no healing. They're going to have absolutely no magic, no stamina, or anything. Dodge tank. Tank is now hit as well, I'm not sure. Maybe he dodged it. I think he dodged it. Okay, nice. If the healer gets it, you're going to have big problems generally until her resources are back up. And it's super hard to dodge again. Dodge Hela. Dodged again. Quick stupid question. Templar healer, which race should you pick? I think it's High Elf, right, or Dunmer? Dunmer for PvE, High Elf or not. Dodge. Dodge. Liss is hit by it. Liss, go in the water. Heal the healer, you'll be fine. Oh shit, that was a miscast. Healer's dead, I'm resing. I got it. Take the boss. I got it. We're gonna raise our healer here, so you gotta get hit a few times. It's really important that you dodge that AoE, because the arrow, sorry, because if the arrow does hit you, dodge, tank. If the arrow does hit you, you can say goodbye to all your resources. Buy this game if you ever want it to take over your life, exactly. But that's what you want, that's the point of playing a game, right? Almost all the attacks this archer interrupt or dodge. Almost all the attacks are interruptible from the boss. That can make it a lot easier, because as long as you've still got stamina, you're able to bash everything. The only thing is that dodge. If you don't get the dodge, you're fucked. Dodge. We're going to execute the boss. I'm actually going to ignore the adds at this point. We can kill the adds after. Just because this boss is really hard hitting. I got main aggro. Dodge. This is hit. And we're just going to execute the boss. So as long as you avoid that arrow, it's absolutely fine. But, yeah. We had a few hits, but we're still okay. Only the one death. Could be worse. And then we're done with this one. We're getting there pretty fast. It's certainly a good run. How's it going, Adam? Welcome to the stream, mate. Robo the Healer in Divine. So that's 15k right there. Easy money. And we go to next arena. UK Pirate coming in with a 10. UK Pirate. I appreciate it, man. Our biggest supporter, always regularly donating. I greatly appreciate it, man. I'm glad you're enjoying the stuff, and I appreciate the donation, buddy. Very kind. All right, so this one is a little more complicated mechanics. This one we have to work quite well as a team. So what's going to happen is we're going to get these little slaves spawn. The first one's going to spawn over here, but in later waves it gets a little more complicated. I'll update you in a sec, Pirate, after the run, if that's all right with you, mate. So what these slaves are going to do is they're going to walk to these altars and they sacrifice themselves. Actually called a sacrifice, not a slave. When they reach there, they can turn into some real ugly shit. If you get that stuff, you're probably going to wipe. So it's kind of important that you kill this stuff fast. But it's very easy to kill them. You just have to keep aware. And they can spawn on all sides. So middle, west, and east. So hello, I will take the west if that's all right with you. And you take the east and then we meet in the middle.
Yep.
Okay. So one DPS will go either side. Your healer will generally help DPS in the middle. And the tank will keep the stuff in the middle. That's only for the main boss wave. Generally, on the other waves, we're able to help each other. I'm going east, west. No rush. Thank you, man. I appreciate it, mate. It's very kind. And the main tank is just going to taunt everything else away to the middle, just so it's out of our way. We're going to help on the slaver here, just because there's no point in messing about with it. Only on the boss are you going to have to take specific sides. Any good drops yet? Not from DSA. I had another infused ice staff. I got two of those now, which is best in slot, but I don't need a second, obviously. And we're just going to AoE this shit. So that's wave one done. Wave one's pretty easy. You get more and more of those adds the later you go. Why not Breton for the healer? Breton is not quite as good as High Elf, as far as I'm aware. High Elf is the one with elemental damage, and you're going to be wanting to put some damage out, especially in these sort of dungeons. You're not just purely healing. Honestly, the healer spends most time DPSing in this, because the adds die so fast that they're going to spend a real good percentage of the time DPSing. So I'm just going to go cover this one. He's dead. And we're going to go into the main adds. You see, don't use add-ons. People can't see your shit DPS. My DPS is actually pretty good in honesty. I think so. I don't think it's too bad, especially considering I'm really not a PvE-er. Now we're going to get a slave here. I think there's also one on the other side. Do you mind to take my side? I take yours. It's all good. We take them both, man. I come with you. Going to kill both these slaves real fast. Is there anything middle? I think one just spawning. You go, boss. I take the slave. You'll notice again, our healer drops off to help on the side one. On the middle one, sorry. It's just because obviously there's only two of us DPSing. It's really important that we keep someone to cover that stuff. And then we kill with AoE, as per usual. Which DLC should you buy if you're a low level? You should go for Imperial City. It's the best XP in the game. Helm it up. One thing you'll notice is the Templar will generally drop spears for us afterwards if we're stamina. There's no point not to, since we're going to need the stamp to regen. She's probably got better regen than us. So it gives you a good amount. So right now we're going to get these slaves on a few angles. Now, this is where it can get slightly tough. You've got to make sure you're keeping on top of these sacrifices. As soon as you and your other DPS have done the side, you'll generally go to the middle to meet the healers one, because they're obviously going to be less damage. But by them starting it, it's going to be much closer to execute range. If you have a really high damaging healer, slightly less heals, sometimes they'll be able to burst it down themselves. But for the most part, I'd suggest the DPS come to help. And now we're just going to burn this. And again, we're going to get some more slaves. We're going to kill those real fast again. So you'll see most of the time it's us taking the slaves. If you are the tank in this wave, you're going to have a pretty hard time. There can be a lot of mobs to aggro. So if you do find you're having struggles as a tank, you can always get someone to help aggro like 2 or 3, or just accept a couple are going to be loose. My best bet is to just get better gear in, honestly. But if you do struggle, you can obviously do that. And then we're going to burn these final adds. Easy stuff. Alright, now we're going to get one final wave, and then the boss. On this final wave, it's going to be exactly the same. Kill the adds, kill the adds, kill the slaves, kill the slaves. Is the Argonian racial still any good? I think it's okay. Honestly, I don't think it's that bad. People underestimate, I think. Please taunt these ones to my side. So we're going to kill the slaves, we're going to meet in the middle. Generally want to DPS in the middle on this section, in my opinion. It makes it a lot easier. The boss you may take a little off, but we'll explain that when we actually get there. The reason you take it to middle is just so it's out of the way of all the slave action. Because if you're getting hit by the shit whilst you're trying to kill the slave, it can really slow the damage. What monster should you use as a stamina decay? Honestly, you should just use that Veldrift shit. That new thing is so overpowered, but if you can't get that, Bloodspawn. And for PvE, I think it's like Kenna. One Kenna, one Bloodspawn or something. Let's then again, in PvE, you're not going to use either. I'm going to kill this sacrifice. Get all of the sacrifices down nice and easy. Again, this is all easy until the boss. The boss is one of the harder ones. Probably the hardest one of the bosses. Oh shit, sorry.
No, I got it.
I can help. How's it going, Gerald, mate? Welcome to the stream. I appreciate the follow, Bilbo Swiggins. What a name. Templar's just going to throw us some spears. We collect that stuff and we're good to go. Right, so on this boss, the tank is going to start in the middle with the healer. The healer is going to kill the ad there. The DPS is going to kill the east and the west slaves first. So Hela will start on the east, I will start on the west. We'll kill these and then we'll meet them on the middle. And we will start by killing the mage after that. And the reason to kill the mage is he pops in a gate and has much lower health. Now there is one really important mechanic with the mage that is entirely possible we fuck up. And that is that it has to be interrupted. If the mage is not interrupted, it can heal itself super high. And it has some super damaging stuff. Watch out, Lise. So you're going to get a Nova from the main boss and a Negate from the mage. They generally drop at pretty similar times. So as long as you've got some awareness, you're going to know the other one's going to come down. Once that's down, we're going to focus the mage. Do be careful with these mines. They can hit super hard. It's not a one-shot if you get hit by one. Two is going to hurt. So for the time being, we're going to DPS the mage. And in a sec, the tank is going to come back to the mage to help with the interrupts. But not quite yet. For the time being, it's going to keep us away from us. Going to interrupt that. Interrupt that. That's the heal that he does. And now we're going to go to the slave. So keep the interrupts going well. Wellen is now going to interrupt the mage whilst we go to the slaves on our relative side. We're going to DPS our sides nice and easy. We will notice, by the way, one of them has armor on. He's got slightly more health. Healer's dead in the middle. I res you. Take the ad, okay? Shit, I help on the ad first.
No, he's dead.
I res. You got it? Okay, you res. Okay, that Nova is really dead. We've lost our healer and our DPS now. We may even wipe here, which is unfortunate. Take the mage. Interrupt. Nice. The one thing you're really going to struggle with if you're getting wipes, and it's really, really bad, is that it can really fuck up your slave timing. So do your best to keep your deaths down as low as possible. But we're going to be fine now. Okay, take the slaves. It's just going to slow our DPS a bit. You having problems logging in? I believe the NAPC is currently down. We're going to kill ours, and we're going to come help the healer. The other DPS will be there, and then we go back to the mage. And at this point, generally, the mage will be dead. Obviously, we had the problem with the death, so it can be a little slower then. And now we are just going to DPS the mage, keeping stuff interrupted. As long as you've got the mage down, life is so much easier. There's the Nova, we're going to move out of that. Negate is going to drop in about 2 seconds. We're just going to move out of that, and then we're going to execute the boss. Block. Once the boss is down, sorry, we've got slaves. Do not rush yourself on your boss here. You've got to keep the slaves. If you lose the slaves, you are going to wipe. So make the slaves your main focus. No matter how close the boss is, as long as the tank is keeping it interrupted, all is good. It's if the tank is not interrupting that you're going to have problems. No one can get in or out of the game. You can't get out of the game. Or can get in the game. Okay. Yeah, I heard that the NA is having PC problems. The EU has had that a lot recently. And that's the main stead. So now the main stead, life is much easier. We only have to avoid the Nova. We're going to get a few ad waves fairly soon. But again, it's just kill the boss and kill the slaves. But we've done the hard bit now. Getting the mage down is the hard bit. Once he's dead, life is so much easier. Because it's generally the mage that's going to be doing the one shots. This other boss doesn't really do much. I'm casting my DPS like a retard. Nova. We're going to quickly roll out of that. Heal up. Go to our ads and burst down the ads. There is actually a trick, by the way. If you stand in front of the ad, it does actually slow it down. I don't know if it's kind of an exploit or not, but I don't know. But generally, you're not going to need to do that shit. I just thought I'd show you that. The person on the east is generally slightly closer to the boss. So if you're on the east, make sure you come into the middle immediately. If you're on the west, you may find you're going to have some ads that you're going to have to focus. But for the most part, you're always going to come to the middle anyway. Now we're going to get the ads. We're going to AoE all this shit. Appreciate the refollow, Kibi. We're going to AoE all this crap. Once it's down, we're just going to execute the boss again. What are your orc passives? Give you like speed, something to do with stamina, and something to do with two-hand damage or some shit, right? I'm not actually sure. We're going to get one more slave wave here. Even though the boss is executable, in my opinion, it's best not to skip it. Some people will try rush it and try skip it. It can be a problem because if you fuck up, it's game over, basically. So in my opinion, it's better to kill the sacrifice and then go for the boss, because at this point, it's home free. And we're going to be good. That leaves us two waves to go. Nova. Healer's dead, but we're just going to leave it. We're just going to execute at this point, because there's no ads. There's nothing to kill. And we're good. It's really important that you avoid those ultis, though, because those ultis are super high damage. And we're done. Alright, beautiful. So there are now two waves less. The next one we're going to get is the Dwemer wave. Jerking of the healer, and it is well-fitted. Rest in peace. It just me, or has Arcane Willpower's gone up in price this patch? No, it's gone down on PCEU quite a lot. In which alliance am I? I have all alliances, but my main is DC. Twitch is unfollowing people that you follow. That's a bit weird. Alright, so this one, there's a really interesting mechanic that I never, ever knew of until yesterday. Unbelievably, because you used to be able to kill these things. So what will happen is there's these mages that will do tons of damage. The tank needs to taunt before he chains. It's really important to get the aggro on those, because mostly it's going to one-shot you if you don't get the aggro on those. It's really huge damage. He's going to bring them in. We're going to keep the paths interrupting, keep a real good eye on the paths. This is one of the harder waves. As long as we're avoiding that, we're fine. And then we're going to get these massive Dwemer things, and I'll explain what happens when we get those. But yeah, the first job is mostly for the tank. He's just going to make sure he's getting all the aggro on this shit. If you are DPS, obviously help with interrupting this stuff if you can. Obviously, if you're stamina, you don't really have to worry about the negates. Which is why I'm just going to stand in there. Can't use your ulti in there, but it's not the end of the world. And that's all done. Going to get another wave of adds. He's again going to taunt all of that shit. He's going to aggro it. And we're going to burn it. So your main focuses in this are battle mages, dwarven spheres, and the big fuckers that you're going to see soon. But the big fuckers you're going to AoE, and I'll show you how that comes when that happens. I don't even know what to call the big fuckers. What do you call them? Like a titan? I don't know.
Construct.
That's the one. And he's dead. So the first wave is very, again, like almost all of them, super, super simple. There's no complicated mobs here. You never get to see the mechanics in the first wave. Now we're going to move on to wave 2. And wave 2 will start to have mechanics. We'll have battle mates. It will have dwarven spheres. And most importantly, it's going to have the big guys. So I will explain what you can do. I believe this is dwarven sphere hero on the right. Second wave. For the time being, it's just a spin to win fest. Tank will take all aggro. And we'll spin. Negate. Here they come. So these things are going to place AoEs. What will happen is the ice will place like an ice dot, and the fire will place a fire dot on you. You guys need to move up together. But if you're playing really good, what we found out recently is you can actually interrupt the ice guy. It has no interrupt symbol, but if he waves his hand in the air, if you bash him, he can't actually hit you with that shit. So if we just bash him there, we don't get the ice, and we can just burn them down, which saves you so much hassle, you have no idea. If you do get the ice and fire, make sure the person with the fire moves to the ice, because the ice guy is going to be snared to fuck. He's going to be taking a lot of damage. The fire will also take damage, but you're going to take much less damage, and you're going to be less snared if you move together. But apart from that, again, just an AoE fest, as per every other wave. Could you grab this guy to our second guild? And then we're going to AoE. So one of these is going to be a construct. I can't remember if it's back. So the back is our sphere. You want to single target these. These guys hit super hard with a path. He's dead. Once those things are dead, life is far easier. You just spin to win everything until the constructs come. Keep an eye out for the mage paths again. Keep an eye out for any interrupts. But that's mostly the tank's job. He's just keeping a watch on that stuff. But again, if you are a DPS, help out with that stuff. It's going to save your tank a lot of stamina and a lot of hassle. 20k for the necklace. Holy shit, that's quite a lot on NA. We're going to interrupt the ice again. If we do miss it, it's not the end of the world, but if you can get it, it's going to save you so much palaver. Again, the tank is now going to taunt any mages that come. It's going to chain him in. Going to interrupt one more time. We're going to execute the ice so he's out of the way. And then we're going to execute the fire. And then it's just AoE. So there's one of the ice paths. We really have to avoid that stuff. It's almost insta-kill if you do get caught in there. All I can say is don't get caught in there, in honesty. And now we're going to have one more wave. This next wave, there's a sphere over here. So we want to come over here, guys. And the sphere is going to be our focus. I can't remember if it's first or second wave, but you want to get them. Agility necklace is 50k on PCNA. What the fuck? So these guys come straight away. We're just going to AoE them again. I missed the interrupt there, so you're going to see mechanics. So one of us is going to get fire and one of us is going to get ice. Oh, someone else got it. Nice. Good job, guys. Just a spin to win again. Nearly got the ice down. There's probably going to be one more interrupt right now. And we got it. So someone there getting the ice. So you see it on him right now. He can barely move. Someone will now get the fire. They will move together, and that will limit the damage. It will make life easier, and then we're going to focus the sphere. But obviously, you want to focus that sphere fast, but if you are stuck in that fire and ice stuff, you want to stay together, because otherwise you're going to fuck yourselves over. No way is a Zip can polymorph with 800k. That shit's bullshit. You can get Telvar so fast. Don't pay that. You can get, like, 400k Telvar an hour or something. But that's a guide I'm going to have to make off-stream, thinking about it. Okay, and now we're going to get the boss. So this boss is just an individual mage. He's got a lot of stuff that hits super hard and is interruptible. That's, again, the main tank's job, but again, help him out. There's going to be a couple of construct waves, just keeping sure that we interrupt them in AoE. But your main focus is going to be the two mages at the start. There's going to be a healer on the right and a normal mage to the left. There he is. Drop our AoE there. Gonna burn these ads nice and fast with AoE and then focus the boss. This boss actually used to bug out. An interesting fact for anyone interested. Oh shit, don't stand on those runes. It used to bug out in that you could fear him into the wall. Just gonna block the meteor he does. Now that meteor hits super hard. You may find people are dying and saying they blocked. It actually can one hit you through block. It hits like crazy. So if you do get one shot, it's probably the meteor. But yeah, an interesting fact was that you used to be able to actually interrupt the boss through the wall, and it would completely bug out the stage. I don't know if that still happens, so just be careful to drag them towards the middle of the arena. Am I running a stand blade? I am. Now we're going to get our adds and our constructs, and this is where we're going to AoE. You're just going to be really careful of that mage rune. It obviously hits super hard. Interrupt the construct. Actually, I have no idea if I got that. I didn't. Who's fire? Who's ice? What?
Nice.
Well, we got Zenimax there. No ice even came. Oh, it's whatever. So we're just going to go back to AoE. Do you mind to drop a spearless? The whole wave bugged out there. Normally, you're going to get an ice and a fire, but it just didn't happen. Let me kill this. We go back to the boss. Yeah, that... Oh, fuck. Can someone rest? That's why I said you got to avoid the mage rooms. That's my bad. Yeah, exactly. You just solo the mage the bosses, but it's not exactly difficult. It's like 400k Telvar an hour or something. Thank you for that. Obviously, we can die sometimes. Like I said, it's never going to be a smooth run. It's most likely going to be dies almost every time you do this. But generally, you can limit your dies pretty well. Mechanics again staying really simple right now. It's just avoid the AoE, block the meteors, avoid the mage rune, and kill the boss. Interrupt anything you can. Very soon, there's going to be another wave of those adds that we're going to interrupt. The like Titan things and normal adds as well. Just going to avoid that rune. Here they come. Going to interrupt the ice, and we're going to AoE. You'll notice that I personally am standing near it. Shit. I res. Interrupt, tank, make sure you interrupt ice. Oh, you missed it. Fuck. That's not good. So, if you do lose a person here, it can be quite hard to recover. The reason it can be hard to recover is that you get the AoE, and you're going to get spin, and you're going to die. So, what I would suggest is the healer... I wouldn't suggest the healer reds, but the healer's going for it. I would suggest the healer keep the group alive whilst they focus. They're okay though. Whilst they focus on rezzing, and then just go back to it. You shouldn't really die on this wave, in my opinion. It's one of the much easier ones, but obviously the mage could fuck you over. But we're still doing fine here. Gonna kill the last ones, and then we're gonna focus the boss. We're just gonna quickly execute these last two. Am I good? Watch out for the path. List, res. Yeah, it was not interrupted. And now I'm just going to execute whilst the tank, whilst the healer reses our last DPS. I'm going to execute the boss. We're going to block the meteor. It's going to do super damage. As you see, I've got really high health for a normal PvE build, and that stuff still nearly one-shots me. Instead of finding a campaign you own, you don't have to have it own. Just the Telvar place. Or just run a good team. Even if you do it duo, it's pretty good. I'm going to execute him and we're done. Awesome. One wave to go. Now, this one is far more complicated. I'll do the downstairs, by the way, Heller. We're going to get this. We actually got a necklace there that's worth a little bit more. It's not the best set, but it's okay. Like 6k. And this is the final arena before the boss. The nerf drop from the boss in Imperial City, it's hard to get stones now. Really? How much did they nerf it by? Alright, anyway. So, this one has a lot of different stuff going on. There's all sorts of different adds. The adds, generally, you're just going to kill. It's easy stuff. Main focus is going to be the mages again. That stuff hits pretty hard. And you're also going to get ghosts that will stick like a massive AoE out. If you don't avoid that, it's a one-shot. Insta-kill. Apart from that, I mean, really, it's very basic apart from the Zakala and Reuben. And what they are they like mini-bosses, but we'll get to those in the next wave, not this. Or maybe even the one after this, actually, I think. But I'll explain those when we get there. For the time being, we just spin to win the adds. The start is very, very easy. Basically impossible to die. Oh, another thing to mention. There's going to be holes in the floor. Do not fall down there. I will show you what you do downstairs. But do not fall down there in the normal waves. If you fall down there in the normal waves, your group is going to be really screwed. Because you're going to have to live down there. If you do die down there, and it's not that easy, you're going to die. So there's the hole. We just avoid going down there. It's like a black cavern. Am I going to upload this to YouTube when you get beamed from the guys in the wedding dress? I couldn't find the clip, man. Otherwise, I was going to load it. I guess I could have another look. I could have a look after today, I guess. Those are those ghosts. So you'll see them put like a massive version of themselves out. The mini bosses only drop 100 stones, seriously? Well, that is a big nerf. Alright, and we're gonna execute the final adds. But yeah, this bit's nice and easy right now. It gets more complicated when we get the mini bosses. Oh, sorry. Gonna get adds here. Gonna burn this stuff as fast as possible. Again, this bit is still saying simple. I will explain what happens when we get Reuben and Pharaoh, but you'll see me do the downstairs bit just so I can show you guys on stream. I'll generally do it anyway. You wanna run someone when we get to downstairs bit who has some self-healing of some kind. Magicka's Orc's always a great way to go because they can just pop a damage shield. Stamina anything that's using Bloodthirst rather than Flurry and Bloodcraze is okay if they're good. Even I will sometimes die. They really need to manage their blocking or any form of Templar is okay because they're obviously gonna have Breath if they need it. If you do ever fall downstairs, all you gotta do is kill a skeleton. But the reason you try and avoid it is it's gonna fuck the DPS upstairs. If you do have that happen, you can get kind of swarmed by the ads in this, because there's really a lot and it can make it really difficult for your tanks. If you are the tank in this, you're going to be aggroing a lot of shit. It can be quite stressful for the tank, so do as a Templar if you're the healer. Be ready to throw spears to the tank. It can be pretty rough. But they will normally call that shit. This is a really good run right now, actually. We've had a few dies. Probably my best run so far this patch. Okay. Now we're going to get a mini boss, and he's going to spawn by here. And this is where I go downstairs to show you what happens there. I'll quickly show you him spawn. It'll make it slightly harder for myself, but it means you can see what's going on. So right now he's going to spawn in the middle. I think it's straight away. I'm not sure. It's not yet. I think it may be on the third wave then. But he'll be a guy called Reuben or Zackel. And what they'll do is they do insane damage. Insta-kill, basically, if you're not the tank. You have to be the tank to aggro this. If the tank dies, res the tank ASAP. Whoever has it, just roll dodge, because you're going to get killed. Someone else res. But generally, if the tank dies, you're going to wipe. He's going to spawn now, I think. Nope, one more. For time being, then, it is just an AoE. Once we have these normal ads, could you chain this one in, please? And here he comes. So here he is. So I'll quickly show you what happens. What we'll do is we'll DPS him, and in a little bit, you won't see it actually on him, but he's going to take no damage because he's got a large damage here, right there. Oh, shit, I need a res. Hello, hello. Hello, hello. Right next to you. I'm by the boss. Okay, tank's resing me. Tank's resing me with magma. What will happen when he has that up? Shit, block.
Fuck.
Someone's need to res me. We're going to wipe. Rezzing. Hello, so resing. Again. What will happen when that guy comes up is I will go downstairs. I don't actually know what killed me. Oh, I had a lot of shit of aggro. Thank you for the follow, Creepy. We're going to go downstairs now, and we'll get like a mini version of this boss that doesn't have the shield. So every time you come downstairs, whatever happens ad-wise... What the fuck? He's bugged out. Every time whatever happens ad-wise, you're also going to get a ranger, a melee, or a mage. Those aren't really going to be your focus. The main focus is the main boss. I just want to make sure that I'm keeping on top. I could die here. But this can be really hard. You need some self-healing, and you want to burst the ad as fast as possible. Because as soon as he's dead, he loses his damage shield upstairs, which means he's dead, by the way. You can kill him. Which means they can kill him and reduce the damage. As soon as that happens, there'll be a small delay just while the game catches up with the combat, and then you can go upstairs to join your group. You'll help DPS that stuff down, and then you're good to go.
Need to go down again. He's not dead.
No, we're fine. Still time, right?
No, go.
You didn't get it? What? Alright, so if by some miracle you don't have enough DPS to manage to get the boss down there, you have to go down again to get the shields down. That's why you should instantly focus this mini out ASAP. Just because it's going to mean you don't have the hassle of having to come down. I'm going to die.
Go down,
right? No, I'm good. I'm good.
Okay.
Okay. Wow, I got no stamina. I have to kill that other ad first. But yeah, you should never really have to come down here, especially on the final boss. If you have to come down again, it's going to be really bad. Down here can be quite draining on your resources because you're going to have to heal. You're going to have to block a lot of the attacks, interrupt a lot of the attacks. It really wrecks your stamina. Can you throw a spear for me out there, Liz? Any difference between Vet 14 and Vet 16 apart from the mobs? It's a lot more health. It's a lot more damage. The mechanics are the same as Vet 14, but in terms of actual survival skills and things, it's much, much harder. The damage is really big, so you got to pay attention to the mechanics that you could have skipped before. So right now is the next round. We're going to get Reuben over there. He spawns on the east. I'm going to go back downstairs, and I'm going to repeat. The other group is just doing exactly what I said before. They're going to focus the ads. They're going to spin to win, and as soon as Reuben shields down, I will call it, and then we'll make him their focus. This one's quite hard. He does do a wrecking blow. It's really important you avoid that. If you don't avoid it by blocking, you're going to die. But we're good. Once he's down, it's easy. Yeah, he's dead. Dawnbreaker smiting is super good down here if you do have it, or some sort of CCing ultimate. It does make life much easier, but it's fine.
Okay.
You got him?
No, it's okay.
Okay. So they killed him upstairs. That means I can go back upstairs. As soon as he's dead, I go upstairs, and then we kill these ads. And then it's going to be the boss. So the boss, what will happen now is we're going to focus the boss. This guy has loads of different stuff. He has a charge that's a little buggy right now. He charges in the wrong direction. He has, like, the bat ultimate, so he'll heal himself with that. He'll have loads of ad spawns that we just kill as per normal. He'll have a misform that we'll avoid, a banner that we'll avoid, all sorts of different shit. But the most important thing is that someone tells me in the group when he is 87%. Because when he's 87%-ish, I'm going to go downstairs, and that gives me time to kill this skeleton before I get both of the mini-bosses downstairs. Then I will clear them up downstairs. So can one of you guys tell me?
Yeah, sure, I'll tell you.
Yes. You generally want to save your ultimate, by the way. If you're the guy who's going to do the downstairs, I'm rezzing. Take the archer, please. He's on me.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm getting sniped. I'm going to heal me hard. Let's heal me hard. So as soon as it's on 87% chance, that gives us a chance to get downstairs beforehand to kill the zombie that comes before the mini-boss. And that makes the pressure a lot less difficult. Okay, so I go downstairs now, and this gives me time to kill this mini-skeleton, which you'll see. And then I will get, soon after that, as they DPS him, the main mini-boss spawns. It saves you a lot of hassle, because these ones can have a lot of health. They're kind of hard to kill. He's dead, and very soon after that, they're going to have enough DPS, and we're going to get two bosses spawn here and here. We're going to burst those as fast as we can.
Okay, I take heads.
They've spawned, okay. So they're going to spawn any second now. As soon as the shield spawns, by the way, that's when they come downstairs. So here they are. You line them up, drop your ulti, they're going to both fall on the floor, and we're going to kill them very quickly. Ruben's killable.
Just kidding.
Zackle's killable. Coming upstairs. You want to call that for your group, by the way, just so they know which ones to focus. It's very important they focus that down so we don't have to do a second ad wave, because if we do have to do a second ad wave... If they do have to do a second ad wave, you're really fucked. I'm dead. Liss, you need to rest. Come on, guys. Those ads need to die faster. This is Liss. You may get a damage shield here, which is really bad.
I'm dead.
I want to try to get the kill. Take the aggro! Take the aggro! If the tank leaves the aggro there, we're going to wipe. Someone's DC'd. What the fuck? Oh shit, our tank just crashed. Well, that's a little unfortunate, because now we have no tank. But the good thing is we've lost the adds at least. In which case, I'm going to quickly slot a taunt just so we can help. You guys get to see, like, action mode of survival. I'm going to quickly slot a taunt. I will need this for the final boss anyway, so it's not the end of the world. As soon as I can. Just keep living, guys. Okay, I have it. So right now the tank is dead, which means I'm going to take a lot of damage. The reason I go for it is a stamina I can generally move around a lot, and I'm just going to kite the boss. It's going to take us a long time. Liss is going to have to stay with me for the heals and things, but it's going to give us a better chance, because obviously with no tank, this thing's going to hit like a truck. Spear, please, ahead of me. Just going to kite the bats, we're going to kite the misform, etc, etc. No worries. I got the aggro eyes.
Put down my PC.
Your stream works, audio is desynced. I've heard my audio's a little off sync, it's alright, it's not the end of the world. We're going to kite the misform until our tank is back. Hela's going to keep DPSing.
My cat is so
stupid. Oh, it was your cat turned it off.
Yeah, my cat turned off my PC. He just...
Wow.
I don't... He just go on my PC and press the button to open my PC.
Oh. Okay, so I'm going to kite the boss at this point until the tank is back. Hela will generally try to DPS him. I mean, I've got the aggro, so it's fine for him to put as much DPS as he can. The difference is, because I'm not a tank, I obviously can't stand still, because this thing's going to one-shot me. So I'm just making use of the bow passives here and sort of staying away from him a little bit. I mean, generally, you're just going to tank it and DPS it at this point, but we're kind of adapting as we go. How's it going, Maddie? Ellen, welcome. Going to get adds now. This is going to be really hard. You're going to have to kill these adds super fast, Hela. Spear, please, ahead of me. ASAP. No stamina. I'm so dead. Hela, you need to rest. Oh, shit. Hela has tank. Liss, you need to rest. Liss! It's a wipe. Okay, but that wasn't really our fault. That's because the tank died. The tank crashed, so... Yeah. Rest in peace. Hey, it's okay. Once our tank's back, it's going to be much safer. It's not really anything we could do there. I mean... As soon as I didn't have stamina and the spear wasn't ahead, we were wiped. Hey, it's okay, Liss. Don't worry about it. I know you're lacking.
Okay, I mean.
Come on, up you come, little girl.
I come.
It's okay. At least it was no enemy though. Can't reach it in a stamina. But it's all good. It's all good. Tank is now back. We'll just do exactly the same mechanics. I did say we may wipe once. We did. It wasn't really our fault. We actually would have had a no wipe run here if it wasn't for that crash. But yeah, this. I mean, unless I can sprint, that thing is going to slap me. So it was kind of adaption at that point. Your CP 200 and you're too low to play via DSA. Probably going to be hard. I mean, if you're super experienced, you could try. If you follow mechanics, it's possible, but it's going to be tough, especially on the final boss, to get enough damage. You can give it a shot if your tank's 531 and he's doing a good job, potentially. Especially if your healer's DPSing a lot as well. But I can't say it's going to be easy with 231 CP. You're really going to want to be max CP to run this dungeon. Or certainly close to it. Alright, so it's going to be a 30 second delay here. This out punishes you for a wipe just to affect your score. We are going to get a pretty bad time now because of that, obviously, but it's okay. We're just going to AoE these adds once again. Same as before, AoE the adds down to 87%. Watch out for the path. Can you try it with me? I'm afraid not, man. I have a normal group. Can someone tell me when it's 87%, please? Give or take.
Eight.
Okay. I'm going to go downstairs once again, exactly the same as before. I'm going to go down, I'm going to kill the mini ad. Then, just in time, I should have the main boss ads. 87% is kind of your sweet spot with good DPS. It doesn't really matter if you come down even at the very start after the ads. It's just to save the palaver. We're going to kill this one ad. Stream freeze just for you, mate. And as we kill him, the other ones are going to get their shields, which means they're going to spawn here. We're going to drop our ulti right now to get them both on the floor, and we're going to blitz. Zackle's going to be killable. Blitz him fast, please. Single target that fucker. Zackle's killable now. Come on, Hela, you got this. Got to block that Wrecking Blow, or it's a one-shot. Reuben is killable. Then I'm coming up to help those guys kill the other one. Generally, the first one's long dead by this point. The second one's going to be close to it. We're going to go up. Tank has the hardest job on this phase, though. The damage is really big. Most of this stuff hits super hard. The mini bosses are basically everything from the mini bosses insta kill on no block. That's what I mean by the rushes block a little buggy, by the way. I mean, you see there, he runs completely the wrong direction. It's kind of fucked up. Why is the stream break? It's your end. Could someone tell him to refresh in the chat, please? You will notice, by the way, you do not want to be a vamp off of this dungeon. That talent is going to be a one-shot if you're a vamp. And the final boss, which you're going to see, is pretty much 100% fire. It's possible to do it as a vamp, but I would greatly suggest against it. So if you're a PvPer, which a lot of you are probably going to be, from my viewers at least, I would greatly suggest cure the vamp, because otherwise you're going to suffer. Oh dear, Sina, that sounds pretty bad. Alright, right now it's basically mechanics over. You don't get those mini-bosses anymore. All we do is DPS the boss and kill the adds. It's very basic. Now that the tank's still here, it's basically impossible to wipe at this point. Sometimes you can get the odd bullshit die from some AoE or something. Sometimes the tank can miss a taunt, but wiping is pretty much impossible now. So, at this point, there's not much I can talk. I'm just going to DPS. Here come the adds. We're going to place our AoE down. Place our buffs. I don't have my assassination buff. I have my taunt. I'm ready for the final boss. And I obviously had it before for the wipe. AoE all this shit, and we're good. Now we're gonna kill the final boss! Oh my god, I so nearly fell down. If you do fall down, it's not the end of the world. You're only going to have one ad, like the skeleton that comes with the mini-bosses. You don't get the mini-bosses back, but it's really not good to fall down there. It's going to drag out a lot of your time, and if you do die down there, it's really going to fuck your group over, because you're not going to be able to come back upstairs. Someone else is going to have to come downstairs, or you're going to have to manage to kill it upstairs with just three. I mean, at this point, that's fine, but it's just much better not to have that issue, so... Yeah, now it's just a DPS fest. So we're just going to execute... And we're done! Okay, final boss! And then we're nearly done with this full guide. Moving to the final boss loot. Let's go. We've got Ring of Archer's Mine. Not the best, it's like 20k, I think. Something like that, or 10k. 10k. Still not the end of the world. I'm gonna quick repair my gear since I had to die there to save our time. Die or death? I don't fucking care. Alright, so this boss has a lot of mechanics, and you may have to watch this one a few times to understand it. You're gonna need a really good tank. If your tank sucks, you're gonna die. The tank has the majority of the stuff here. Hella, do you want a short slot snipe or something just to deal with the summoners?
Sorry?
Do you want a slot snipe or something to deal with the summoners whilst we're upstairs? Okay. So what's gonna happen at the very start is we're gonna put the tank on this side where he is now, and we're gonna go, when the boss appears, behind him up those stairs. You'll see that in a sec. The tank is going to go over there, and what is going to happen is the boss is going to put fire on him, on anyone in range, and only the person all the way over there is going to be in range. If he was with us, everyone would get it, and that fire spawns an Atronach and does a lot of damage. Now, damage itself is fine. You can heal through that shit, but what you're not going to be able to do is manage to deal with the Atronach. It's kind of a lot of hassle, so the tank will generally take it away, get the Atronach himself, he'll bring the Atronach to the group and drop it somewhere over here whilst the boss is still on the corner. So whilst the fire is up, when it comes on him, he's going to walk over to the lava and stop over there, but we're going to go, for the time being, behind him. We're going to do that, and then we're going to DPS him down to 75%. It's possible I will call a second split. All that is exactly what we're going to do now. The tank is just going to split one more time, run back to the start. It's just a second time doing that, and at that point, what's going to happen is the boss is going to spawn two adds. I'm going to taunt the melee ad, he's going to take the mage and the main boss, and he's going to split with the main and the main boss back to those gates in the distance. That way we're not going to get the fire again. Me, Hela, and Liss are going to kill the mini ad. Now generally your Templar will do that so the other two can DPS, but since I'm running a build where you could DPS it, and if any of you are running a build where you could DPS and it's going to heal you at the same time, you can just do it yourself, just blitz it down. And that means the healer can help DPS as well, it's even faster. We're going to kill that ad, and once that ad is dead, I'm going to do exactly the same for mage. He's going to take the boss back to the gate. I'm going to come here with the mage, we're going to kill the mage, then we're going to nuke the boss. He's going to go down to 50%. At 50%, he's going to pull everyone in. The tank will pop just before that igneous shield to keep ourselves alive, because it can do a ton of damage. It keeps you alive in that section. Then the healer is going to heal you to full. At that point, we're going to nuke him down all the way to zero. At 25%, he's going to spawn two adds. About 50%, he's going to spawn two adds. The tank will just aggro both of those. You're going to ignore those. And at 25%, he's going to do another pull. It's entirely possible that's in the gate. So before that, the Templar will pop a barrier. When the barrier is up, that will keep you alive. You'll all roll out of the gate, and you're going to full nuke the boss. If you do get Atronachs during that space, fire during that space, just spread out, keep nuking the boss, and you're good to go. But you're obviously, that's a lot of information to take in, so we'll do it as we go. So come over here, Hela. Are you going to drop a snipe?
No. Yeah, I'm going to do it.
Okay.
Oh, sorry.
Okay, come.
I think it's okay.
Come. We won't do it. We'll do two splits just to play it easier. Unless we find really close. Okay. So right now you can see him in the distance doing that emote. That sticks a fire on him, which you see him running around with right now. We'll go down to him as soon as that emote stops on him. It stopped now. We can go down to him. That means we can't get the fire. An Atronach will spawn where that fire comes, and we're going to nuke that Atronach. Now it's a little weird. It'll go down and then heal back up. Just kind of ignore that. It's going to heal up now. And then you want to drop your ultis at this point. There is one really important attack to avoid from the main boss, and that is like a tornado. If you don't block that, you can say goodbye. It's going to one-shot you. So do keep a big eye out for that in terms of DPS if you're close combat. But apart from that, it's DPS fest. So very soon that's going to happen. I think we're actually going to be able to nuke it. What's the boss health, please?
Block. 88.
Now?
84.
Okay, let's split one more time. Let's play it safe. So we're going to split one more time. We could have potentially nuked it there, but we're just going to play it safe. Hella.
Yeah, dot.
Okay, mate. I just play safe, you know. So all the DPS and the healer will come here. He's going to drop the fire over there. We probably could have nuked it down, but it's generally better to play it safe, because if you do get the fire there, you're going to wipe.
Okay, we'll need him.
Okay, let's get ready. Wait. Now. He gets the flame. We're going to kill the Atronach. Quickly kill this, and then we're going to nuke the boss under 75%, and that's when we get the ad phase. And that's where stream pressure is going to fuck me up, and I'm probably going to make a mistake on the boss. It won't even surprise me. Nuke down the first ad. He's dead. Nuke down the second ad. And here we go. We are now going to get the melee with us. So we're going to taunt him. He's going to come with us, and we're going to take him all the way up to these stairs. You want to keep him fairly close to the front. The reason we keep him there is in a sec, as you'll see, he'll place a heal circle. Watch out, Dawnbreaker. You don't want anyone to stand in front of him apart from the guy tanking, because he'll drop that Dawnbreaker. If you don't block it, you're going to say goodbye to your health. Obviously, I'm running a self-sustained build. Sorry, I lost his taunt. I got it back. Which means we're not going to need the heals. It can help you a lot with the DPS to get this guy down. And then he'll place that heal ring. We'll just move him a little out of that to here. Place him again at a new angle so they can get behind him. Obviously, it can be a little difficult for me to see here. Heal, heal, heal. If you do miss a block, generally the healer will just sort you out like that. Can be quite hard to get them all, obviously. Just block him with Jewel Ward and shit. But then we're just going to nuke him a little more. We're going to block that. We're going to nuke him a little more. He's placed another heal ring. This will be the last heal ring. I'm going to block. We're going to ignore the fire for the time being. He's going to live. The healer will now drop down to him. So listen, if you go help him as soon as the fire's gone. The healer will now help the tank whilst we are up here. Take the summoners. Shit, that's your job, Hella. These summoners, it's really important these die quick. They do a horrible fire attack that can really fuck your run. Generally, you want to kill this as you go. Now we're going to kill the Atro, and then we're going to kill the mage a little bit, and then at that point we're going to split. So I'm going to take the outro real quick, and then I'm going to taunt the mage. I'm going to split off with the mage just to play it safe. If you're really good DPS, you can actually just DPS the mage then the boss, but we are not going to try that.
I
got the mage. I keep the mage. Okay, when you get the mage as the taunter, you want to run all the way to the back, so if you're the healer, the DPS doing it or whatever, so that way he'll come as far as possible. We're then just going to stand in front of it, and we're going to nuke him. Interrupt that cast. He'll also place a fire AoE. You want to make sure that's coming off the rest of your group. So that will come pretty soon. I lost the aggro again, because I'm shit at tanking. Avoid the Majorian. That's a one-shot. Oh, he blocked it. Nice one. Interrupt that. Pretty soon the boss is going to get fire. Nice one, Sinnet. Interrupt. Heal, heal, heal. I'm low stamina. Heal, 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 heal.
Okay, knife flame.
Okay. We nearly finished this mini-ad. Once this mini-ad is dead, life is far easier. This is basically a hobbit. Once this mini-ad is done, we're pretty much done with the fight. Okay, nice one. What's the health of the boss, please? Kill these. We kill the summons. I take left, you take right.
61.
Okay, we're fine. We're going to kill the second summoner, then we're going to kill the Atronach and the boss together. I'm going to res. Lissy res. He's going to be fine. As soon as the Atro is dead, we're going to focus the boss. We need to get him under 50% before the fire. If we get the fire, we may as well wipe because it's going to be much harder. But generally, it's pretty easy if you've got relatively okay. Tell me when it's 52.
55, 54, 3, 2.
Igneous now. So he's going to pop Igneous. You'll see I get the damage shield. He's going to pull us all in right now. And we're going to get a large amount of damage. It's going to nuke all of our health down like so. Healer is instantly going to heal us up. We're just going to step away. And now we're going to put full nuke on the boss. We ignore all mechanics at this point. As long as your damage is good, you have the ability to do that. So we're going to keep nuking the boss as fast as we can. Very soon there's going to be adds come. Here they come. The tank is going to aggro both of those adds. You may have to block the original attack of one of them, which we've done. What's the health? Get ready with that barrier list. When it's like 28. There's the barrier. Very soon we're going to get pulled in one more time. There's going to be a negate drop in a sec. There it is. That's why you drop the barrier. Watch out for the AoE. Shit, tank dead. I'm rezzing. Pray that's not on me or we're going to die. We may well die here. I think I got it. I got it. We're now going to nuke the boss for a spear, for a spear, for a spear. We're going to nuke the boss as fast as we can. That's why you pop the barrier there, though, guys. If you do get caught on the negate, it can fuck you. If the boss drops any UE, it can fuck you. It's kind of RNG, that section, but apart from that, we're just going to nuke it. We're probably going to get fire in a sec. When we get that, we now spread out a little bit, just so we're not killing each other. Everyone has charged onto me. I don't know why. And that was extremely close, but we've done it. Reds up, you're too fast.
I can't. It's in combat.
Okay, now I have to kill the archers. But yeah, we are down now done, guys. That is the end of the loot. So, in a sec, we are going to pop the dramatic music on for the loot. See, I better not do that. Since I'm recording right now, I actually can't do the dramatic music, but I'll keep it nice. We're going to quickly kill these archers. If you do have deaths at that point, it can be a little problematic because you're going to get the fire. But apart from that, you just want to kill this shit, and then you can go up this little light, and then you are going to see how we get the final loot. Well done, thank you. But yeah, I will upload this on YouTube, guys. Don't we worry about that. It will be there. I will highlight and pop on YouTube. So now we go up these portals. We go flying. It looks pretty cool. The graphics are cool. You can look all around. It's really nice graphics. Really cool stuff. And we get the final chest. So this is where we need the chat hype. Can I see that exclamation mark dream spam in the chat, please? The dream. Can we finally get a good loot? Maybe when I'm recording, you know? Maybe when I'm recording, that's when I'm going to get a good loot. Because normally I get jack shit. I have terrible luck at ice staffs. I always get an ice staff, and that's so bad. Okay, guys. We're going to do this one by one. Hellar's going in hot. Hellar is taking the first loot he's going to get. He's doing his kowtow. I'm going to join him. You know what? Wait for it. Okay. We're doing this. Do you want first loot, Wellan? Wellan is going in for the first loot. And the first loot is... He's going to link it for us. The Master Sword, don't you dare get sharpened. Powered, okay, not so great. I don't know if that increases the healing of the sword. No, it doesn't, does it? So unfortunately, a shit loot for him. It's a cool weapon, though. Master Sword's really cool, but it's not the best trait. Next, Hellar is going in hot for his loot. Hellar takes...
Oh my god.
It sounds positive. The Master's Greatsword charged. Welcome to RNG. Liss is coming in for loot number 3. And Liss gets... Let's get.
You don't even want to know.
Link. God. Is it an ice staff? It's probably an ice staff.
It is an ice staff.
It is an ice staff. Always the fucking ice staff. And guys, this is our moment to finish the video. Not the stream. I'll still be streaming for a long, guys. Don't you worry. I'll probably do MSA after this and do the same guide. But this is it, guys. The dream. It's not an ice staff. It's a bow. Come on, baby. For the stream, be infused or sharpened. I beg you, be infused or sharpened. It is... decisive. Again, another decisive bow. Oh boy. Well guys, thank you for watching. This has been an excellent guide on how to do the DSA. It's been pretty fun to do. I will continue my stream, but I will end the YouTube video here at this point. So thank you everyone, and I will see you again in the next video.